Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I am back with another video for Hashicorp Consul. Consul is a tool for service discovery, configuration, key value store and many more. Today we are discussing service discovery and key value store service along with installing the Consul, storing the AWS access and secret key for the Terraform. So let me pull out couple of the diagram to explain the service discovery and dynamic configuration features. Look at this diagram. It is three-tier application architecture. In this diagram, requests are coming from the load balancer to IIS web server for the demo website. Then demo website connecting to F5 load balancer for SQL server cluster, then cluster sending request one of the available SQL server. It is very common and most popular architecture of three-tier or two-tier application when services are tightly coupled with each other for a application. When these components are decoupled on multiple network, like one of the components are located on AWS, one of the components are located on Azure, and some of the components are located on local data center, and especially when components are located on containers, where containers are coming and going in every second. In this situation, maintaining all the services and components with this architecture are little bit difficult and time consuming tasks. In this scenario, Hashicorp Consul play very important roles. Let's see how. Same application architecture, but components are located on different network, plus Consul service introduced in this diagram. Let's see how we are using Hashicorp Consul service in this diagram. There is Consul cluster is running and SQL Server 01, 02, 03 register themselves has a SQL service to the Consul cluster. And now IIS web server make a query to Consul cluster and asking where is my SQL server. Consul cluster provide the list of the SQL server to the IIS web server. Then IIS web server make a directly call to SQL server instead going to via Consul cluster. There are many benefit to use Consul service over the traditional load balancer. For example, IIS web server or application will directly call to the database server instead of coming from F5 load balancer. It remove the latency between web server and database in complex and big environment. Second major advantage of this architecture, when your application are hosted on containers or decoupled on multiple location and components are creating and deleting very frequently. If we are still using the F5 load balancer architecture, then we require to add and remove the components manually each time, and this exercise takes longer time. Whereas we can register the components to the Consul service during the bootstrap process. It takes very less time. So this architecture has so many advantages over the traditional architecture. Let's look at the second feature, dynamical configuration. This is the diagram for the airline booking system, and this application has multiple components like booking, loyalty or coupon, and payments, and each and every components are connecting with third party components or remote services. In the traditional way, remote or third party components APIs hard coded into the application code. There is no problem in this architecture until unless there is a maintenance on remote service or third party components. In this condition, you require to manually edit the configuration for the third party APIs and components. How come the Consul service help here? Instead of hard code entry for the third party components, you can give the reference of the variable that are hosted on Hashicorp Consul service. So now what you need to do? You just need to modify the entry of the backup device in the console, and the console dynamically update on the application side. You don't really require to touch or edit your application code to modify the configuration setting. Let's move on. Third feature, KV, key value store. We are completing this exercise practically. In this exercise, we are installing the console service and storing the AWS access and secret key so that we can give the reference of these keys to Terraform. I'm using the Ubuntu machine for the demonstration. Download the console from the Hashicorp. Unzip the file and it is simple executable. Now let's copy this executable on bin folder and verify the accessibility. Yes, it is available. Let's set up the console as a service on this machine. Let's create a file called console.service. This is going to be a content. I'll upload this file on my GitHub account. You can download from there. I'm starting the console service in a development environment where cluster and agent is running on same machine. I'm installing the UI interface for the console service. Bind option. If your environment has more than one IP address, then console service bind this service on a default port like 127.0.0.1. Instead of that, I am binding this service on actual IP address of the machine. This is the IP address of the machine. Client. It is service expose address. It means that console will listen on this IP address from client side. And finally, node name. And this is the node name. Once you are done, save this file. Before starting the service, let's look at the host file. Let's modify here. Now we can start and enable the service. Service is running. Let's verify the members. I'm getting the error connection refuse because console by default try to access agent list on this IP address, but we configure the console service on server IP address. Let's try to access on client IP address. And this is the node name. This is the IP address of machine. This is the default data center name. At this moment, development environment is up and running. Let's try to access console service on UI interface. You can access the UI on port 8550 along with client IP address. Yes. And one service is registered. You can check the nodes. Currently, one node is added. And health is good. We are going to create and store key value. You can set up the access control to limit the privilege. So now let's create the key value. You can create the key value from the console command line as well as from UI. So click on create and give the path name with key. So I am giving the path name AWS and I am going to store all the key under this path. Go ahead and save it. Now let's create key and value under this path. So I am creating the access key. This is my AWS access key. Go ahead and save it. So I created access key under AWS path. Let's create one more secret key. Click on create and give the name of the key. And this is my AWS secret key. Go ahead and save it. So I successfully create and store a combination of AWS access and secret key, and I will give the reference both the keys into Terraform so that Terraform can access AWS resource API to create the resources. I hope you enjoy in this video, and don't forget to watch my next video on the Terraform. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.